The PICTEK gaming mouse is an Amazon.com bestseller that comes in at around $17 or $15, depending on if you opt for the slightly older version of the mouse without RGB lighting and an 8th button. But with a shocking amount of competition in the budget gaming mice scene, including an offering from Amazon Basics which I've already reviewed, how does this option stack up? Undeniably, the first thing you will notice about this mouse is that RGB lighting. Now, if you prefer a more minimalist look for your peripherals, then this is really not for you. But for everyone else, if your setup is full of RGB strips, fans, keyboards, and mouse pads, then the RGB puke aesthetic of this mouse should fit right in. But nobody buys a gaming mouse based on how it looks alone. Or at least they shouldn't. So, how does it feel in the hand? Well, it's a bit of a mixed bag, to be honest. The biggest, or should I say smallest issue, or feature, depending on how you look at it, is its size. Now, I don't have particularly big hands, and this mouse isn't small per se. It felt pretty okay to pick up for the first time, but after some extended use, I had a hard time getting over how my pinky just kept sliding off the side of the mouse, and overall how I couldn't really get enough of my hand on the mouse to be comfortable in the hybrid way I hold the mouse. I suspect that claw grip users will find the mouse more comfortable, but unless you have smaller hands, palm grip users may just find this mouse unusable. But other than that, everything else about the hand feels pretty good. The soft touch plastic on the top feels great, although is easily scratchable, and the rubber grips on either side satisfy the sweet spot for me between texture and smoothness. The accents of glossy plastic aren't great, but back to the LEDs, those are. The mouse flexes a bit, but seems pretty durable, with the only major letdown being the plasticky cable with a great USB end, but overall is just meh. Funnily enough, the buttons get almost the exact same set of comments. The primary and secondary buttons are great, and scrolling is nice, with Mouse 3 not having very much travel, but an okay click. I ended up really liking the fact that the mouse has a DPI up and down, with my only complaint being that they're a little bit too loud. And much like the cable, Mouse 4 and 5 leave a lot to be desired, honestly feeling mushy and unstable, and just kinda bleh. Which all leaves the last button, the game button, as PICTEK calls it. And this is where I'm sort of confused once again, as although the button feels nice, I have a hard time reaching it without extending my thumb out all the way, which makes me question the design of the mouse, as if I look at the hand feel, my hands are too big. Which makes it all the more surprising when you feel the weight of the mouse, being quite heavy. This mouse is definitely not a mouse for high-level esports, but for single-player games, as well as casual competitive play, it should be completely fine, as the feet on the bottom do let the mouse slide nicely around. Now for the software. It comes on a disc in the box with the mouse, however, as I do not own a disc drive to actually get the contents off, I looked online and unfortunately came up empty-handed, being unable to find a legitimate download from either the seller or the manufacturer's website. However, from what I can tell from the screenshots on the Amazon page, it seems to function much like the Amazon Basic software and looks to have good functionality. Luckily though, the 5 DPI presets are okay out of the box, although I would have preferred a little bit more on the lower end of the spectrum. As far as lighting is concerned, there are 6 modes other than the one you've been seeing primarily in the rest of this video, all controlled from one small button on the bottom of the mouse. You can set it to always show the DPI color, fade in and out of the main colors, have a sort of pulse effect for those main colors, have it smoothly fade between all the colors, there's a laggy, for lack of a better term, rainbow effect, and there's also a 7th mode where you can turn the lights off completely, which is a surprisingly good range for built-in options that are easy to control. Which leads me on to just some strange quirks about this mouse. For DPI switching, once you reach either extreme of the mouse, you can only click the button to go closer to the middle of the settings, make it seem like one of the DPI buttons is unresponsive. On Mac, and probably Linux, although I have not tested it, mouse 4, 5, and the game button didn't work. However, they work perfectly fine in Windows, and the excuse the manufacturer said is because of software conflicts. So I guess, in conclusion, if I used a claw grip to hold my mouse, or I had smaller hands, then, as long as I was willing to live without customizability, I think I would really enjoy this mouse, and think it was great bang for buck. However, I don't have small hands or a grip where this mouse would be comfortable, meaning that for me, and I think a lot of others, this mouse really just wouldn't be a good choice. Instead, I would recommend the Amazon Basics gaming mouse, which features a bigger design, software you can actually get, but unfortunately lacks that wonderful 2018 RGB puke. So I guess PICTEK, you tried, and some people will love you, but for the rest, not so much.